What's up, guys? Sanchez here. I want to give you guys my review of Florence and the Machine's Dog Days Are Over. And the reason I want to do it is because it's pretty weird. It's a creepy music video. The song in itself is kind of creepy too. I mean, it's about like the end of days and everyone's dying. So naturally, I guess, yeah, the music video would be creepy, but it's got a lot of pro-Illuminati, pro-New World Order symbolism in it. And I just figured I'd make this video to kind of point out what I see anyways. I'm sure there's a bunch of stuff that I won't even see in here. Before I even start, I want to let you guys know that I don't think Florence and the Machine is in the Illuminati. I don't think any musicians are in the Illuminati. That the Illuminati, that whole power structure is so tight and secretive and dark that they would never allow in some just musician or whatever. It doesn't work like that. It's just that these musicians just show their loyalty to the system by continuously doing the eyeball thing in their music videos or showing Beelzebub or Baphomet in their music videos. It's strange. It's this new thing that's happening. And I think it's because they just want to make it all super cool to the young kids, to the trendies. So here's my review. So this music video has this girl here in all white, and then a preacher girl, and then also another insane looking woman who just dances insanely. She'll come out right now. This one right here. This lady, she pretty much farts throughout the whole music video. There's the first one that she laid, and it's all she does is dance crazily and just basks in her farts the entire time. Until the end of the music video, where she just decides to kill everybody, as you will see. Again, like I said, this song in general is very dark. It's about the end of days. There she is basking. The lyrics just say it themselves, you know, run fast for your mother, your father, the horses are coming, you better run. These blue chicks are pretty cool. They probably symbolize something too. I don't know what it is, but they're just damn sexy. It's got a very religious, churchy tone to it. Very Baptist church-y. Like she's looks like a preacher at one point and just leading a choir. But the funny thing about it is that there's these guys right here are straight out of Eyes Wide Shut, the little harp players right there. But yeah, this music video, that's the minister lady that she plays. This one. Yeah. It's got a very churchy vibe, Baptist churchy. It's weird because the actual music video has nothing to do with God at all. It's just like promoting the new religion, which is pretty much the religion of Mother Earth, saving the earth and being a trendy and everything like having to do with that, as you will see in this music video here, as it'll start to show you. I mean, it's a good song. I'm not gonna knock the song. It's got a good beat to it. It's like a tribal drum beat. It's catchy. Especially when it hits its peaks. Here they come. You have a little demonic boy right there. This part of the song, she says, "And I never wanted anything from you except everything you had and what was left after that too," which is pretty weird because it's Orwellian doublespeak is what it is basically. Kind of like what politicians do. They'll say one thing when they're trying to become get into politics, and then as soon as they get in, they'll say the exact opposite of what they said they were going to do. Everyone does it. Obama, Bush, just forget about it. And this is like what she's saying in this music video is, "I never wanted anything from you except everything you had and what was left after that too." I heard this guy, I was doing some research on this song. This guy on the internet was saying that the dog days are over is code for the God days are over. Like he was saying that the word dog reversed is God. And that's basically what the song is saying. I don't know about that, but it's pretty interesting because if the world is going to end, this is the end of days type of song. Yeah, we're kind of like, in our society, it's kind of leaning more toward getting rid of God in general. It's been like more and more refused in schools. And just people in general, they can't even hear a conversation about God. They just, it makes them upset. So it kind of makes, his theory was it's the God days are over. I could see how that would be, but I don't know, who knows. Little demonic boy again. I think that's her son. I heard that someone said that was her son and her daughter right there. That's why I'm calling him demonic boy. All right, this is where the music video is going to get good and pretty much go in with what I was talking about. Yeah, I'll stop it there. The United Nations, like we all know the United Nations as being humanitarian. They're there to help and create peace. But that's actually not what the United Nations is. It's a very, it's different than that. It was brought into place to be viewed as that, to on the front and on the cover to be a good thing, but it's really not. It's just one step in them trying to create a new world order, which is them just making one form of government for the entire world that everybody would be under just one law. And that's just like a stepping stone to that. The UN is involved in all kinds of crazy shit. For example, they have this thing that they proposed called, it's called Agenda 21. If you go on Google, search Agenda 21, you'll see all kinds of websites about it. But then you'll also see, even Wikipedia here talks about it. It's an actual plan proposed by the United Nations. And to just kind of break it down for you, basically says that they want to lower the population of the world to save the earth, basically. You could do Google searches of Agenda 21 maps, and it'll show a map of the United States with like red all over the place, and or some color like that, and it'll say these are the areas where human beings will no longer be allowed to live or to go, only in these small little compact areas. This is where human beings will be allowed to go. It's, think about the Hunger Games, that's what it is, where you have just these small areas where people live and work, they're like camps, and then there's the huge areas where the elites will live. It's not like they'll leave it to the, for Mother Earth. No, they want it for themselves is the point. It's Hunger Games-ish is what it is, that's what the plan is. And in order for them to pull it off, a part of it was would be that they would need a lower population of the earth. And so they don't say how, but they're basically saying we need to just wipe out a shitload of people. It's just insane to think about that that's an actual plan and they proposed it. Reminds me of the Georgia Guidestones. The Georgia Guidestones are these stones that are like the equivalent to Stonehenge, wherever the fuck that's at. But here in America, it's the equivalent to that. This is what they look like, basically. Yeah, there's these giant stones that have written on them in different languages the new commandments for the new world order, like the new government that's going to be coming up. It's pretty freaky. The freakiest one is the first commandment here, which is maintain humanity under 500 million in perpetual balance with nature. The earth's population is like what, 7 billion I think it is, and this stone is saying that they want to maintain it under 500 million. I'm not really that good at math, but what is that, an 80% reduction in humanity? 85? I don't know what that is, but that's a lot of people that would have to not be alive in order to follow this commandment here. And it's just like, It's insane. I don't know why these stones are still standing. How come they haven't been destroyed by patriots? I don't know, but it seems like something that is offensive to humanity. Anyways, this goes along with the UN plan of Agenda 21 and lowering the population of the world. That's what they want to do. The elites want to kill the majority of the people on Earth. You know, they want to lower it by 80, 90%. Who knows? Well, why am I talking about this? The reason I'm talking about this is because in this music video, that's what they're pretty much pushing. All right, so moving on here. The beat drops, okay? And you got that fart lady running right there. I missed it. I should have stopped it right before then. There she is. Okay, yeah, this lady, flatulence lady, and she's running with this light blue flag. And she's gonna be killing people. And you're gonna see people running away from her as she's holding this flag up. They're running away from her and this flag. And she just, I don't know, she explodes them. She's got powers or something. She just kills everybody in this music video. And it's strange, but the reason why it's strange is because the flag is a light blue flag. And guess what the United Nations flag is? It's a light blue flag. It looks just like that. It's the same thing, only difference is there's no United Nations emblem on this flag that she's holding here, but it's a light blue flag. You know, same people that said they want Agenda 21, lowering the Earth's population, and she's gonna be killing people right now, as you'll see. Look at all the people running from her. This guy, that guy, they're all running. There we go. Boom. She just exploded someone right now. Another person. And what was funny about that is that she blew up a second ago. She blew up one of the blue ladies that was with her. And the reason that's why that's funny is because those blue ladies were with her. They were on her team. But yet she doesn't care. She's still going to kill them anyways. And it's kind of symbolic to the people who sell out to the system and actually go along with it, thinking that they're actually going to get a seat with these elites. It's not going to happen. They're actually going to get the same treatment as everyone else. They're going to be killed. They're going to be destroyed. They don't know that. They think they're promised this and that, but in fact, they're just being used and they're going to die same as everyone else. Waving the flag. Agenda 21. Population control, lowering population. And it's such a beautiful thing. It's right at the peak of this song where it's the best part of the song. It really is. And here she is, just like nothing, nonchalantly just killing everyone. And it's like a cool thing. It's like you like it. You like the fact that it's happening. But it's from Mother Earth, so it's good, right? Yeah. Agenda 21, United Nations. I mean, look at this flag. It's a light blue flag. United Nations flag is like this. That's that flag. She killed everybody. Just destroy the population of the people in the music video. Is it a coincidence? It might be a coincidence, but it's fucking weird, isn't it? I just wondered myself, did Florence know that that's what this video is about? Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. A lot of these musicians don't know. They just kind of like, they're happy to be famous. So they let somebody else handle the music video and they trust that that process is going to be done well. And a lot of times they know and they don't care, whatever. It could be either way. But it's pretty disgusting that, yeah, they just are blatantly telling you their plan. Agenda 21. And by the way, they don't call it Agenda 21 anymore. They realize that too many people knew about it, figured it out, so they call it other names. But it's still the same thing under the same plan of eventually they want to get to a point. They're tiptoeing closer and closer to pass legislation all the time that will eventually lower population and bring in this new world order, one world government, so that they can implement this reduction in population of the world. This music video is disgusting.